Good morning, students. So welcome back to Digital Signal Processing class. In today's class, we are going to discuss the concept of your TMX3266XX processor. So in that, the basic thing what we are going to learn is what is that particular architecture is all about and how this architecture is going to be designed for various digital signal processing applications. So before proceeding with today's class, so in the last class, we talk about the sampling rate conversion of I by D interpolator and decimator concept we discuss, and the reason why we are going for down sampling and up sampling that also we covered. In today's class, we are going to see the basic introductory part of unit 5. So in today's class, I'm going to give you introduction of unit 5. So unit 5, what actually the point we need to understand is unit 4 and unit 5 are quite easy and it's theoretical and it's very simple. If you proceed further for these concepts, it will be easy for you to get it. Those are not familiar with the numericals, those are facing the problems in the numericals, you can proceed with unit 4 and 5, but it requires your concepts with the processors. That means you should know the theory behind the processor, what is a processor is going to do it and how it is going to work. Meaning is that you should know the idea of your microprocessor, microcontroller, that is nothing but MPMC concepts, that is nothing but what is a processor, what's the addressing mode, how the addressing is mode is going to be work. If you had a processor, how it is going to work in a pipeline mode. So pipeline mode is also one of the concepts we do have, that is called fetching, decoding and executing of any data, right? So normally when you want to talk about any type of processor, you should know that what is the meaning of the processor. So processor means what? When you want to proceed, when you want to have a computer, in the computer, the heart and the brain of the computer is a processor. The main concept, the normal concept of the brain is considered to be the processor, right? Without the processor, you can't process the data. Data cannot be processed. To get the data to be processed, your processor needs to work in a very sophisticated manner. Meaning is that it should work for less amount of time. It take accuracy should be more, precision should be very high, and the bits needs to be higher, right? These are the points we need to consider when you want to design or when you want to talk about any processor. In processor, first thing what you have to see is, we have to see its architecture. Architecture, okay. Second thing, it's addressing mode. And third thing, it's addressing mode architecture, then it's registers. How many bit it registers it has. Then fourth is, it's a normal programming or it's working, you can say. And fifth will be application, where it is going to be applied. Means for what kind of application it is going to work. So these are the things you need to consider when you want to talk about any sort of processor. So first thing would be what? In the first part, we are going to see its architecture. What is it? Architecture means internally how that particular processor is going to be designed, right? So if you want to talk about one specific processor in our digital signal processing is TMX320CXX, right? The XX means what? These are different versions. So that XX indicates what? It can be 64-bit, 32-bit, depends upon the number of bits. It actually designed by a different, what we call, different number of bits processor. So that XX we do have to see. All will resemble the same architecture, but the number of bits and the little bit what we call upgrade version of the previous one with a new one would be there. Like when you want to see the Windows, Windows XP, Windows Vista, then Windows 7, Windows 10, now different Windows we are using. So this is what actually the previous one, it's slightly upgrade version of the next one, right? So this is the way, this also is there in your digital signal processing. So we have to see that architecture of TMX320C5XX processor. So in that we are going to work in what actually we are going to see, that also we are going to design that particular processor architecture. The next we need to see its addressing mode. What is addressing mode means? which is your source and which is your destination. Means what? When you want to pass a data, how data can be passed from source to destination? From one register to another registers, how it is going to pass? So like immediate addressing mode, direct addressing mode, indirect addressing mode, implicit addressing mode, explicit addressing mode, there are different addressing mode for different types of processors. So we need to understand the way the data can be passed from one source to another destination. On what basis you are passing the data? So that can be understood by using the addressing mode. Clear? Next we do have a register. So what is the registers means? Every kind of processor is going to take the registers. Based upon the registers only it is going to pass the data. So if you specifically see this particular architecture of digital signal processing, we are using 32 bits registers. We are using different 16 bit registers. There are different versions of different types of registers we are using, which is nothing but the operands. When you had the opcode and operand to pass the data, opcode means what? Operational code. Operand means what? The bit, the information what we are passing. Suppose you had the accumulator and you are writing the data of 30H. So that means accumulator is nothing but that register which is taking that particular data is called operand, right? So this register is taking that particular operand and how it is going to work, that can be understood by using the registers. The next is what? Programming. So since whatever the things we are going to learn all come under the programming part, and how it is going to work on it, that is also the main important factor when we want to see any kind of processor, not only digital signal processor, any kind of processor. Next is the application, where it is going to be applied. So now come back to our main concept. What is the DSP? What we call processor. So basically in digital signal processing we are having two types of processor. One is general purpose and a specific purpose. The general purpose means which can be used everywhere, all whatever the scenario we are having for all types of processors. When you want to see it, that is nothing but general purpose what we call processors. That is nothing but one of the example is this one. This is called general purpose digital signal processing processor, which are having high specific speed when compared to the microprocessor with the architecture, and they include fixed point processors such as tech stack instruments. So this is what I'm saying, fixed point. Who has explained this one? This is explained by tech stacks, tech stack instrumentation, instruments. So this we know, this is the organization who has given this TMX processor. So this is a company we can say, right? So that company have explained this architecture of TMS32C0XX processor. So they said it is a fixed point processor which given by Texas Instruments, which is going to have different series of it. So those are called general purpose digital signal processor. And special purpose are what? So these processors are designed for specific algorithm using FFTs. So what is FFT students? It is what? Fast Fourier transforms. Based upon the FFT, that is explained by the Mylitz multi-channel telephony voice eco cellular processors. So this is also we had by using FFT processors. Based upon the FFT algorithm and FIR filtering, there is a specific purpose processor is there that is also used in digital signal processing. Okay, so our main concept is what? How do we understand this? This is the only architecture we had to identify. That is general purpose digital signal processor. That is this version. This version only we are going to see its architecture, its complete concepts related to the TMS320 320CXX processor. Next. So till now we have explained about the programming. Next is the application. So application means what? In which field it is going to be used. So these processes are used in every field. In communications, in the image processing, in digital signal processing. When you want to pass a signal to one end to another end, in the antenna and wave propagations, that what we call. In the communication, main important part would be these processors. That processes will be used the communication domain, because in communication there are different kind of communication. Wireless is there, wired communication is there. They are based upon the ranges. We had different types of communications, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, Zigbee. There are different old versions and new versions. When you want to see all types of domains, this kind of processors has been used, and that is a part of their application. So this is just an overview of your unit 5. So in unit 5, this is just thing you have to understand, and architecture of this particular processes and all those things we are going to see in the next class. Thank you.